Everyone knows earthquake and typhoon hit Japan every year. There are many active volcanoes around the country, but they are not all. The snowy cold climate and long coastlines are just another factor that greatly affect the safety of the people, which is protected by infrastructure in Japan. Thanks to their challenges, civil engineers in Japan have come up with a way to design, construct, maintain the infrastructures that can withstand those harsh environments. This is one of the reasons why Japan has been the leading country to develop the advanced technologies that not only prevent damage to the structures, but also protect people's lives. Let me show you one good example. The Akashi Kaikyo Bridge. This bridge is famous for the two reasons. First, its two anchorages use the concrete that can compact itself, which in fact the Japanese invention. Secondly, it has the longest central span among all the bridges in the world, despite the fact it was built in the area often hit by strong winds and earthquakes. The role of civil engineers is to develop the technology that is not too complicated, but can be implemented at a minimal cost. A good technology can assure the long service life of the infrastructure, which contributes to global sustainability, since the amount of the material and energy resources needed can be reduced. The technology developed in Japan is suitable not only for the developed countries, but also many developing countries where much more infrastructures are now being constructed. Japan is the best place for you to learn civil engineering.
Hola, my name is Kira and I'm from Venezuela. I'm doing a master in combustion science here at Hokkaido University. I love airplanes and engines, so in order to make them better, I want to improve their performance. I think if we can understand what is happening with the flame instabilities in a jet engine, we can improve its efficiency. This reduces the fuel consumption and helps us to tackle the pollution issues. It sounds cool, isn't it? It is, but it requires a lot of work, a lot of reading, and a lot of experiments. But that's okay, because I love what I'm doing. For me, Japanese language is so difficult that it would have been almost impossible to study it here without the English program. And since there are a lot of students from all over the world, you can experience a multicultural environment where you can feel that you are traveling to so many places at the same time. Living and studying here is not so easy sometimes, but thanks to the EQ program, this is one of the best things that ever happened to me. Because once you have been in Japan, you can actually say that you have seen the world.
I think that it has a good environment to study in because you are very close to nature. So if you like greenery, if you like snow, please come here to study.
I feel Hokkaido University has one of the most beautiful campuses around in Japan.
Japanese people are nice to foreigners.
The best part, I think, are the labs and the professors. The course is basically in English, so I don't have to spend too much time studying Japanese.
Yes, it provides a very good opportunity for foreigners who really like Japan and cannot speak in Japanese to have chance to stay in Japan and study in Japan.
With the ever-rising of human population, and development of infrastructures, the demand for energy and environmental issues have become more and more complex and important. Energy conservation in the buildings and the houses are very important because energy consumption in this sector occupies about 30% of total energy demand, and it has been increasing steadily. To help tackling the energy demand issues, we have a long history of research works related to low energy technologies. For instance, we have developed an integrated compact heat pump unit which can provide up to 45% reduction in energy consumption compared to conventional air conditioning and boiler system. The earth itself has huge heat capacity and abundance of stored thermal energy source from solar radiation. By knowing how to extract this energy from the ground for daily use, we'll be able to depend less on the fossil fuel and reduce the threat to global warming. We have been working with the industries to develop innovative ground source heat pump system for heating and cooling. Today, you can see this heat pump system being used in houses, commercial buildings, as well as greenhouses. In this campus, we implement the ground source heat pump system for floor heating, air conditioning, and snow melting. To establish the low energy and sustainable society, we continue to study and develop the innovative high energy efficiency system which can contribute to being more improved quality of life.
it's quite interesting to study with foreign students. Actually, I have never experienced study abroad, but I can make foreign friends, learn traditions or cultures of many countries in this EQ program, even in my home country.
So you can stay there.
Aerodynamics is a branch of fluid mechanics in which we treat the motion of fluid and its interaction with a solid object. As you know, when the object is placed in a flow or moves in the air, aerodynamic forces such as the drag or lift act on the object. The precise estimation of such aerodynamic forces are quite important when we manufacture industrial products such as a road vehicle, train, or airplane. Accordingly, we have been developing a new computer simulation software called Front Flow Rate Aero for these 5 years. The code is based on unstructured finite volume method to treat a complicated geometry of industrial products together with a large eddy simulation technique to treat unsteady phenomena around the road vehicles. With the tight collaborations between our group and the automobile industry in Japan, we have been applied this numerical method to various industrial problems. Our group also have tight collaborations with many supercomputer centers, including world fastest one in Kobe, Japan.